So I numbered them out, cleaned them up, cleaned towel, clean rag, cleaned inside the bore here, lubed it up. This one is number 4. And this one is number 3. The rods are numbered also, the way that I took them out. A little indication on there of where. Not too bad. Lifters right here out of a Chevy. I forget. The 27AU15C1. These are good lifters. Just like the old school Harley ones. I think they're like cheaper too. So we put the lifters inside here, roll the lifter around to the side it needs to be. So I marked the number on the front side, so I remember doing that. Put the pin in here. So you can see my paper clips, the rubber bands. You can't go to this side until you know that these are free. I just spun the crank right now, so they're not free, but, and I wasn't recording, and I thought I was, but anyways, if you wait for about 7 minutes, 7, 10, 15 minutes, these will be completely free. You'll be able to just spin them. If you're not able to spin them, then you can't go onto the next side. But these ones are able to go. I'm able to go onto the next side. I've spun the crank with the old stator. I've spun it with the old stator and a 36. And now both sides are in position, or they're both moving at the same time. This back one is coming down, and this other one is starting to go up. And it, just like that. So this side should be able to be adjusted, and it should be at the very base of the lobe there. So let's check it out. Okay, I put some brand new O-rings in here. I put the cover on here, and I put it here with the rubber band just like before, and we're gonna start unscrewing it and making it longer right now. This is the guts of it. So you got the cap, spring, washer, O-ring. Okay, let me slide it right in here, and then we'll do that. Backing it out, and it's making it longer. I never really look at it, but I'm backing it out, holding the bottom, making sure. I'm gonna put this back up on this little squash nut, put it up most of the way, and now I'm still backing it out. I don't want this nut to go down there, but I don't want it to interfere up here either. So, that feels pretty good right there. Mechanics not cleaning off and inspecting your tools, the really good mechanics will make sure that these are straight. Make sure they're cleaned out, make sure they get oil, all that shit. Okay, here we go with this. Holding the jam nut, holding the top, unscrewing the bottom. Faced up again. So remember, we just space those up by hand. Don't force anything. When it stops, that's it. Just like that. And we will start. Now I'm gonna turn the crank again and show you guys in position where they need to be. I was able to verify through this other one, but I just want to show you guys where we're at. Boom, right there. Both of them are moving at the same time. That means these ones right here at the very bottom, ready to be adjusted. We're gonna go check with the hand again. Okay, that was good. Okay, the lashes out on both sides. Feeling good about that. Pink mark right here and a pink mark right here. I'm gonna use those pink marks as reference. And I'm gonna go one pink, two pink, three pink. Then three and a half pink. Okay. Now I'm gonna run up the jam. So I'm gonna grab my other 7/16. See, I don't wanna spin the bottom. I need to spin the top. And then I'll do the back side. We need to go one pink, there's two pink, there's three pink, and we'll go three and a half. Three and a half. Now I'm gonna run up this jam nut. I don't want to move the bottom wrench, just the top wrench. Or else. Oh yeah. And I usually put blue Loctite on here. I just had it, but I forgot. Damn it. Oh well, good intentions. So, I'm gonna come back in 15 minutes and these should be spinning freely. All of them should be spinning freely, so I'll show that to you, and then we'll put the covers on and we'll be done with that, and we'll be working on something else. Stay tuned for this. So it's been about, I was putting on my covers on this side, it's been about 15 minutes. Now you can see I'm able to spin it even with the little quarter inch part down here. So quarter inch, 2 7/16.